It's late afternoon, immediately after the close of our last episode. A moment ago, Suzanne Barclay was ready to tell Perry Mason all she knows about Gus Jansen. She was beginning to overcome her remembered fear of Jansen because he was a memory. For months, she hadn't seen him, or felt the touch of his hand, or heard his voice. Only memory kept her fear alive. Then, a moment ago, here in the supposed safety of her own home, and despite the guards protecting her from any contact with Gus, Suzanne received a message on a tiny slip of paper. And when she read the words written in August Jansen's own hand, her compulsive terror returned in full force. Now she strikes a match with shaking fingers, destroys the note, and then goes through the connecting door to her mother's room.
I'm almost ready, darling. And just in time. One of the policemen came to my door and told me Mr. Mason's here.
Mother, I want to use your telephone.
Now? But Mr. Mason's here, darling.
Please, Mother.
Why?
I want to phone Uncle Donald.
Suzanne, is something wrong?
Of course not. I just want Uncle Donald to know that I'm going to tell Mr. Mason all I can. Uncle Donald's ashamed of me.
No, darling.
Oh, yes, he is. He's ashamed of me for being a coward. And I want to tell him that... Oh, Mr. Mason won't mind waiting for just a moment. You can promise him I'll only be a moment. And I want to use this phone because... The police aren't listening in on this phone, are they?
No, but what difference would...
Can't you understand, Mother? I'd be embarrassed having a stranger listen when I speak to Uncle Don. I want to say that I've been a coward and I'm sorry. Well, you wouldn't want anyone listening if you... What is it, Mother?
The police made it very clear they want to monitor any calls to you or from you.
Call to Uncle Donald?
Well, it...
Oh, you know it won't make any difference. I've spoken to him by now. Tell Mr. Mason I'll be right along, please.
All right, but hurry.
I will. Oh, Mother, where's your phone book?
Hmm? One of the policemen borrowed it when he used the phone in the hall. But why do you need a directory? Don't you remember Donald's number?
Oh, certainly. I just happened to notice...
Suzanne, is something wrong? Darling, you're pale. Would you like me to stay while you call?
No, Mother. Please let me speak to him alone, please.
Of course, dear, but hurry.
Will you give me the number of the horse and carriage? It's a restaurant. Yes, I know it's listed, but I don't have a directory. Yes. All right, thank you. Hello? Horse and carriage? Let me speak to Gus Jansen. Mr. August Jansen. Are you sure he isn't? All right. Thank you. No message. I'll call back.
Suzanne?
Who is it?
It's Stella Street.
Oh, Miss Street?
Yes. Aren't you going to let me in?
Well, just a moment. Yes, Miss Street?
Hi, Suzanne. Your mother asked me to tell you we're in the upstairs sitting room.
Thank you very much. I didn't expect you so soon.
Mr. Mason doesn't like to wait. He's awfully glad you've changed your mind, Suzanne.
Miss Street.
And I want to tell you that I'm very proud of you, honey.
Thank you.
Well, are you ready?
Well, you go ahead. I'll be there in a moment. I have to finish dressing.
Oh?
Yes, I want to finish combing my hair. Tell Mr. Mason I'll be there in just a moment. Just as soon as I comb my hair.
Okay. You hurry up, though, honey. We can't wait for you.
Just tell them I'll be right there, please. Thank you, Miss Street. Hurry as fast as I can.
Meanwhile, miles away.
Well, here we are, Katie.
Horse and carriage. I'm going to get you the best steak you ever tasted.
I hope I'm able to eat it. Gus, I don't like driving so fast.
Well, we were late, my dear. Here, let me open the door. I like it here.
Oh, it's lovely.
Now, wait till you see the steak. Oh, here comes Mike.
Who?
Mike, he owns the place. Oh. Hello, Mike.
Mr. Jansen. It's great to see you again.
Thanks, Mike. Oh, this is Miss Beekman.
Hello, Mike.
Miss Beekman.
You hold my table, Mike?
You know I did, Mr. Jansen. All right, this way.
Mr. Jansen was afraid you wouldn't save his table.
Okay.
Yeah, he should have known better, miss. I save a reservation all night for Mr. Jansen.
Now, knock it off, Mike.
I mean it. Well, Mr. Jansen's one of our most important customers. He used to bring his friends here all the time.
Mike.
Business friends. Here's your table.
Now, you sit down, Katie. I'll phone the garage to pick up my car.
Stay here, Mr. Jansen. I'll call for you.
No, I'd rather. You come with me.
What's up, Mr. Jensen?
Did I get a call?
How do I know? Just a second, I'll check the slips. Some dame called you a couple of minutes ago.
Okay, we go in your office. It's a private call.
Betty, switch any call for Mr. Jensen to my office. How was I to know it's business, Jensen?
Okay, okay.
Right in here. Would she call again?
Yes. When she does, tell your girl to get off the line.
She knows to get off. Will you drink the usual?
Nothing.
Huh?
Nothing. I don't drink anymore.
Yeah? Big changes, huh? You got a new girl, you don't drink anymore. That's a good-looking kid.
Yeah.
She's as pretty as the one you used to bring in here. Yeah. What is it, Jensen? What'd I say?
Mike, you know me?
Sure.
You know me from a long time back. I know things about you, you know things about me.
You know I'll keep my mouth shut, Jensen.
Which is why I'm here. And, Mike, you know I mean what I say. Forget the girl I used to bring here, Mike.
Forget it?
Forget you ever saw her with me. Understand?
Okay. Only I like it better when I'm asked to do a favor.
Mike, I'm telling you.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Hello.
Is this the horse and carriage?
That's right, miss.
Has Mr. Jansen come yet?
Oh, just a minute. Here you are.
The girl?
Yeah. She's scared to death.
Give me the phone and you get out, Mike. Get out.
Hello? Hello, is anyone on the line?
There's someone here, Suzanne.
Gus.
How are you, darling?
Don't.
Sue, darling.
Don't call me that. Gus, I only have a moment. They're waiting for me.
Who?
The people.
Cops?
Yes. Police.
Have you told them anything?
Yes, but
don't lie to me.
Not lying.
Mike, then listen.
Gus, please, it's too late.
Shut up and listen. You're in a spot, Suzanne, and because you are, I'm on the hook if you talk.
Gus, I've got to.
You've got to tell nothing. Not a word, nothing. Keep your mouth shut if you love your mother.
Oh, Gus, please.
Because you love your mother, and you know what'll happen to her if you talk.
I can't ask you questions. I don't know what to do.
I'll tell you what to do.
I can't.
Shut up and listen. I'll tell you how to handle it. Lose your brains.
What?
Lose your brains. Now listen to me. Listen, Suzanne, as you've never listened before. As you love your mother. I say you're going to lose your brains. Lose your brains. And by that I mean... Gus Jansen's scheme has worked so far. He's actually talking to Suzanne Barclay. And as the result of what he's telling the terrified, bewildered girl, well, you'll want to hear tomorrow's vitally important development. So, by all means, join us, won't you?